स्वेच्छाकेसरिणः स्वच्छस्वच्छाय आयासित इन्दवः त्रायन्तां वो मधुरिपोः प्रपन्नार्तिच्छिदो नखाः. दृष्टपूर्वा अपि हि अर्थाः काव्ये रसपरिग्रहात् सर्वे नवा इव आभान्ति मधुमास इव द्रुमाः. सो इन् दट् फोर्त् कारिका वि लुक्ड् एट् अ कपल् आफ् एक्साम्पल्स् वेर् दि अर्थानाम् आनन्त्यम् आर् एन् अपूर्वत्वम् अ न्यूनेस् केन् बि कान्ट्रिब्यूटेड् बै ए न्यू पोयेट् who can use the same idea that is there before, but if he expresses it in a different manner using vyangyam or dhvani, then it takes on a very beautiful shape. We looked at Evam Badavi Devarsho, how that is much more beautiful than Varakatha Lapaha, Krite Varakatha Lape, Kumaryaha Pulakodgamaihi, and all that. We looked at a couple of examples like that. Yatha Vyangyabeda Samashrayena, ध्वनेः काव्यार्थानां नवत्वम् उत्पद्यते व्यङ्ग्यभेदं. वि ओन्ली लुक्ड् एट् द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ फ्रम् दि आस्पेक्ट् आफ् व्यङ्ग्यार्थ, वि डिड् नाट् लुक् एट् इट् फ्रम् द व्यञ्जक. सो व्यङ्ग्यभेदसमाश्रयेण ध्वनेः काव्यार्थानां नवत्वम् उत्पद्यते, जस्ट् लैक् हौ वेन् वि लुक् एट् द एक्स्प्रेस्ड् मीनिङ्ग् प्रतीयमान अर्थं, तेन नवत्वं काव्यार्थानां नवत्वम् उत्पद्यते. न्यूनेस् केन् कम् देर्, अ फ्रेश् क्वालिटि फोर् अ काव्यं केन् अपियर् द सेम् वे. तथा व्यञ्जकभेदसमाश्रयेणापि भवितुं शक्नोति. तत्तु ग्रन्थविस्तरभयात् व्यञ्जकं केन् बि वक्तृ बोद्धव्य काकु, आल् आफ् दीस् आर् अर्थव्यञ्जकाः बेस्ड् आन् इवन् शब्दं पदम्. Everything can be a suggestor, pratyayam. The third udyota deals with vyanjaka there. Pada prakashyata, vakya prakashyata, prabandham. Everything can serve as a suggestor for the rasam, which is vyangyam. So, tattu grantha vistarabhayat neglikhyate swayameva sagridayaihi abhyuhyam. So, as a conclusion, he says, whatever is possible vyangyamukhena, is also possible vyanjaka mukhena. Vyanjakanam to anantyam atra. So if I have to give examples for each and every vyanjakam, then grantha vistarabhayat nalikhyate. Atracha punav punaha uktamapi sarataya idam uchyate. Fifth karika. Vyangya vyanjaka bhave asminne vivide sambhavatyapi rasadimaye ekasmin kabihi syat avadhanavan. Again and again, I have to stress this point, that a poet has to be extremely careful, cautious. Avadhanavan syat kavihi. Kutra kavye. Kasmin kavye? Rasadimaye kavye. Ekasmin yeva. So, ekasmin vyangya vyanjaka bhave. Asmin vyangya vyanjaka bhave. Asmin ityukte artha anantya hetau. Why do, even though artha anantyam is there, but vyangya vyanjaka bhave vichitre shabdanam sambhavatyapi, because of the vyangya mukhena arthanam anantyam bhavitum shakyate, vyanjaka mukhena api arthanam anantyam bhavitum shakyate, vividhe sambhavatyapi tathapi ekasmin neva avadhanavan kavihi kavina yatna kartavya. Kutra vyangya vyanjaka bhave yatra rasadimaye, where the rasa gains prominent. Angi rasam, what is the angi rasa, what is the pradhana rasa? The poet has to be extremely conscious in of the rasa that is pradhanam here. He should not get carried away by the other things. Rasa bhava tadabhasa rupe hi vyange tad vyanjakeshu cha yatha nirdishteshu varna pada vakya rachana prabandeshu avahita manasaha kavehe sarvam apurvam kavyam sampadyate. Only when the poet is avahita manaha, where in prabandham, in varna, padam, vakyam, from there the rasa is understood. So rasa bhava tadabhasa rupe vyange. Vyangya vyanjaka bhavam, he has to be concentrated on vyangya and vyanjaka. What does that mean? Vyanjaka also means shabdam, also means padam. He can't be constantly looking only at the vyakarana, vishesham, meter, etc., etc. Normal word becomes a vyanjaka, vachaka shabda becomes a vyanjaka only when we understand the vyangyartha from the same word. Then the vachaka shabda is no longer categorized as vachaka, it is called as vyanjaka. So what can be a suggestor, what can be a vyanjaka? Varna can be, padam, we've seen those in both Kavya Prakasham and in Dvanyaloka. So Varna Pada Vakya Rachana Prabandheshu Avahita Manasaha Kavehe Eva Sarvam Apurvam Kavyam Sampadyate. Only he can create a beautiful and unique poetry, unique Kavyam. Tathacha Ramayana Mahabharata Adishu. Now where have we seen that? Udaharanapurvam Atra Vakti. So Tathacha Ramayana Mahabharata Adishu Sangramadayaha Punav Punaha Abhihita Abhi Navanavav Prakashante. Sangramadayaha. Ramayana and Mahabharata are categorized as Itihasam. Itihasa, there are many different battles that are being described again and again. In Mahabharata, especially, there are Parva and Parva, which describes the right from Karna Parva, Bhishma Parva, everything. Bhishma Parva and then Karna Parva. Okay. So the battle is being described again and again. There are conversations that are repeated again and again. In Ramayanam, you find the Vipralambam constantly, entirely throughout the whole itihasam, right from the time when Rama goes to, you know, with the Vishwamitra, he goes for the Yagarakshanam. There also Dasharatha feels very sad that a small boy has to be sent there. That Karunam is highlighted there. When he goes for Vanavasam, there is an extra, it just culminates in the Sita Vyogam at the end, where she is banished by Rama. Right, so the intensity with which the Karunam is portrayed in Ramayana keeps on increasing, as we see from Vishwamitra's time, then the Vanavasa, and then Sita Apaharanam, then they join together, there is a brief interlude of happiness, and then she is again forsaken by Rama because of that insult or rumor, right? So prabandhe cha tathacha ramayana mahabharata adishu sangramadayaha punah punaha abhihitaha api. Even though battles and other descriptions are being again and again described, navanavah prakashante. You see, very new and beautiful. We don't even understand, or we don't even feel it's boring, no? Even though it's the same battle that has been described again and again. You have the battle between Vali and Rama, Vali Sugriva and Rama there. The first one was Subahu Marichan battle is there. Then Karadushana battle, Viradha. There are so many Rakshasas he fights, and Valmiki is not stingy in describing all this. The description of Karadushana Yuddham goes for 2-3 sargas there. And then Vali episode, and then Rama Ravana Yuddham. There are so many episodes of that Sangrama coming again and again. In the Mahabharatam also the same thing. But it's beautiful because it is interspersed with other Angarasam also. Prabandecha Angi Rasaha Yekayeva Upadnibadhyamanaha Artha Vishesha Labham Chaya Atishayamcha Pushnati. Prabandecha in a Prabandham, in a work, Ekaha Yeva Angi Rasaha Upanibadhyamanaha. A poet Upanibadhyamanaha Nirmitaha Kavina Nirmitaha. Ekaha Yeva Angi Rasaha. Artha Vishesha Labham. It gains a great beauty because of the artham that is used. See, it's only the Vengyartham, and from the Vengyartham there is a Rasa Pratiti in a Prabandham, like an entire work. Chaya Atishayam Pushnati. It's a great beauty that the Angirasa contributes to the enjoyment of the poet. So, Kasmin Niva Iti Chet, the example is Yatha Ramayane, Yathava Mahabharate. For Ramayana, he just spends one line or two lines, and then for Mahabharatam, this paragraph and paragraph for Mahabharatam. So, Ramayanam is very simple here. Ramayanehi Karunaha Rasaha Swayam Adikavina Sutritaha Shokaha Shlokatvamagataha Ityevam Vadina Nirviudascha Saeva Sita Atyanta Vyoga Varyantam Eva Swaprabandham Uparachayata. This Shokaha Shlokatvamagataha has been given only by Abhinav Gupta, the Anandavardhana. It has not been given by Adikavi. He's got a misconception here, I think. So Ramayanehi Karunaha Rasaha Eva Sutritaha Adikavina. You can do a full stop there and say Shokaha Shlokatvamagataha Ityevam Vadina Anandavardhena वर्धनेन सूत्रितः यु केन् से स्वयम् आदिकविना रामायणेन करुणरसः एव इति सूत्रितः प्राबब्लि यु केन् से इट् मीन्स् इन् फ्रम् द श्लोकं मा निषादत्वागमः शाश्वती समाः इट् इस् दट् वि अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् दट् द पोयिट् मस्ट् हव् एक्स्पीरियन्स्ड् वाल्मीकि मस्ट् हव् एक्स्पीरियन्स्ड् दट् करुणरसम् इन् द फस्ट् उद्योतम् while he was talking about the shoka krauncha dvanda vyogottah shoka shlokatvam agatah in that the lochanam he says natu munehe shoka the valmiki cannot could not have been dukkitah if he had been dukkitah then the rasa atmata iti niravakasham bhavet you cannot have rasa atmatvam there it becomes a rasa only when there is an aaswadana yogyata tatra vartate दुःखस्य आस्वादनयोग्यता नास्ति नोबडी वाण्ट्स् दुःखं दुःखं तु परिहर्तव्यं दुःखं तु न आस्वादनीयं रैट् सो मुनेः शोकः नास्ति सो वेन् ही सेड् शोकः श्लोकत्वम् आगतः क्रौञ्चस्य शोकः मुनेः श्लोकत्वं मुनेः फ्रम् द मुनि मुनिवरात् श्लोकत्वरूपेण आगतः दट्स् हौ यु हाव् टु इण्टर्प्रिट् दट् वर्ड् सो न तु मुनेः शोकः अत्र इति अन्वयः सम्भवति एवं सति तद्दुःखेन मुनेः दुःखेन वाल्मीकेः दुःखेन सो न तद्दुःखेन इत्युक्ते क्रौञ्चस्य दुःखेन वाल्मीकिः अपि दुःखितः इति कृत्वा रसस्य आत्मता इति निरवकाशं भवेत् देर् इस् नो स्पेस् फार् रस आत्मा रस केनाट् बिकम् दि आत्मा आफ् द पोयेट्रि न च दुःखसन्तप्तस्य एषा दशा वेन् समन् इस् इन् ग्रीफ् नोबडी फील्स् लैक् सेयिङ्ग् ए श्लोक हियर् वेन् यु आर् क्रैङ्ग् अदा पुळि पुळि अळुदन्ट् श्लोकं चलनं तोणमा नोबडि विल् वाण्ट् टु See, so Muneh Shokaha na Shlokatva Rupena Parinataha. It is only, he is moved, he was moved by the scene that was there in front of him. That is why the Shloka came about. So, Evam Charvana Uchita Shoka Sthayi Bhavatmaka Karuna Rasam Uchalana Swabhavatmaka. Sa Eva Kavyasya Atma, Karuna Rasasya Eva Kavyasya Atma. So that, it is not Adi Kavina Sutritaha Shokaha Shlokatvam Agataha is not correct. You just have to say Adi Kavina Manishada Iti Uktam. For that shloka is a representation of the Krauncha's Shoka and the Shoka Sthayi Bhava that is there in his mind, which has become a Karuna Rasam. And because of that Karuna Rasa Parinamaha, it's that shlokaha is a result of that karuna rasa aswadaha nirviyudascha he ends his entire work ramayanam sita atyanta viyoga paryantam eva he ends it with the atyanta viyogam total separation from rama that you have to consider uttarakandam also here many say uttarakandam is not the work of valmiki it is a later interpolation because valmiki ends with the rama pattabhishekam people maybe they have said that the language is also different and so they say that uttarakanda is not there the truth is probably valmiki did not want to highlight that and end it on a sad note in keeping with the tradition of kavyam writing in India in Sanskritam literature maybe that's why people say that he must have stopped with the Pattabhishekam and he would not have written the Uttarakandam but the story as such it is now available along with the Uttarakanda also Yuddhakandam and Uttarakandam because the story is available and it ends with on a tragedy So Sita Atyanta Viyoga Paryantam Swa Prabandham Uparachayata. Anandavardhana is of the belief that he has written it. Nirviyudaha Saha Eva Nirviyudaha Kavyarasaha Eva Nirviyudaha Samaptim Vitaha. Mahabharate Abhi in Mahabharatam it is Shantarasam. Yeah, in Mahabharatam यदिहास्ति तदन्यत्र यन्नेहास्ति न तत् क्वचित् सो द धर्मे च अर्थे च कामे च मोक्षे च भरतर्षभ यदिहास्ति तदन्यत्र यन्नेहास्ति न तत् क्वचित् वि फैण्ड् nothing that has not been touched by Mahabharata. Everything has been addressed by Mahabharata. In Ramayana, if it is about an ideal person, Mahabharata is about the confusion that is there in this world is represented beautifully. It is not about how you should live, or it is more about how people live in this world. What are the different dilemma that people face in this world? And that leads to a vaimanasya, a vairagya. The disillusionment that you find because of the different shoka that exists in this world. Whatever we try to achieve in this world, everything is, Bhartrihari in his Vairagya Shatakam, he will say, Saramya Nagari Mahansan Rupatihi Samanta Chakram Chatate. Sacha Udvruttaha Rajaputra Nivahaha Te Bandinaha Tak Kataha. Parshve Tasyacha Sa Vidagda Parishati Taschandra Bimbananaha. Parshve Tasyacha Sa Vidagda Parishati Taschandra Bimbananaha Techo Udvrutta Rajaputra Nivahaha Udhrita Sacha Rajaputra Nivahaha Te Bandinaha Tahkataha Sarvam Yasya Vasha Dagat Smritipatham Kalaya Tasmai Namaha. You can talk about a great kingdom, a great the Saramya Nagari, beautiful city, Mahansan Rupatihi, a great king, Samanta Chakram Chatatu, with a lot of Samanta Chakram, a vassal kings. Udvrittaha Rajaputra Nivahaha. The princes were all not arrogant, but they were very confident, and they were going around because of the under the shade of their great father and king. Taha Kathaha, those stories and beautiful ladies, all of these became for a moment, Smriti Patam Agat. You only think about it today and remember it. It is not there. Present Kalaya Tasmai Namaha. Time just makes everything vanish, and it only remains as a memory for us. There is an English poem also, Ozymandias, though I don't remember correctly. About a great sculpture, there is a sculpture there about a king who must have been so great, and that his sculpture was also big. They wanted to represent the king in such a manner. But today, nobody. It's just a small memory or one line in history books that gives us that nirvedam. It's a dukkhatmakam. Everything ends in a very bad manner. Virasa avasanam. He takes that point and says, Mahabharate api shastra kavya rupa chaya anvayini Mahabharate api shastravat tattva nirnayakam. Talks about Dharma Shastram. It is a Dharma Shastra text. There are so many dharmam that is being said there. Dharanat dharma ityahuhu dharmo dharayati prajaha. It is there in Shanti Parvam. Dharmo dharayati prajaha. Because it is dharma that conditions people, and it is the one that supports people, dharma is talked about in at lengths in Mahabharata. Dharanat dharma. So it is like a Shastram. It gives Tattva Vivekam also is there. If you take Yaksha Prashnam, it's Ascharyam Yat. People keep coming and going, and nobody, Tathapi Ahitam Acharayat. People keep performing bad deeds to others. It's the most surprising thing in this world. And nobody wants to look for an eternal state. Nobody wants to find or pursue something that gives eternal happiness. So Shastravat Tattva Nirnayakam. Kavya Rupa Chaya Anvayini. Chaya Shobha Anvayini. It also has the beauty that a Kavyam gives. Kavyam is Kanta Sammitataya Upadesha Yuje. So Shastram is like Mitra Sammitam. Prabhu Sammitam, Mitra Sammitam, and Kavya is Kanta Sammitam. So Tadrisha Chaya Anvayini also. Yeah. So Mahabharate api, Mahabharatam, as an adjective for Mahabharata, he says Shastra Kavya Rupa Chaya Anvayini Mahabharate api. What is the end that is shown there? Vrishni पाण्डव विरस अवसान वैमनस्य दायिनीं समाप्तिम् उपनिबध्नता महामुनिना. Vyasa shows the end of all of these great clans. It has got a very bad ending for all of them. Right? Vrishni is Yadava. Yadavanam sakshat Sri Krishnasyapi virasa avasanam eva. Virasa avasanam is not a great end. It's a very, for a great person like Krishna to be hit by a hunter. The entrance of Kali is shown in that manner. La? So Vrishninam api parasparakshayaha. They try to cheat Durvasa by showing a man pregnant. So he gives birth to a mace, a club or a gada. And that gada is churnikritam and it is put in the earth. And then that's how it goes, right? The story. They all fight with each other and then die and on the shores of Dwaraka. And a bit of it, of that gada goes into the is eaten by a fish, and that a hunter finds that bit and takes it as his arrow. With that arrow he kills Krishna also. So vyada vidvatva vyadena hataha Krishna vrishninam yadavanam api parasparakshayaha pandavanam api Mahapathakleshena anuchita vipattihi. Mahapathakleshena, so they are on their way towards Swarga. Each one falls down from that mountain. That is to show how even great people can have a very bad end. Virasa avasanam. Vaimanasya dayini. Vaimanasya dayini, when you read about the end of Pandavas or Yadava or Kauravas, a great description of their life and the kingdom, the way they rule, in a contrast to the end they suffered, it gives rise to a vaimanasyam. Vaimanasyam is uru dukkham. Dukkha dayini, dayini samaptihi. Tadrisha samaptim, tadrishim samaptim upanibadhanata mahamunina vyasena. What is he trying to show us? Vairagya jananatatparyam pradhanyena swaprabandhasya darshayata. He's trying to show us that the pradhana Vishayam here is only Vairagya Janana. Whatever you may try to enjoy, Bhogana Bhukta Vayameva Bhukta. It's only you who gets degenerated at the end when you try to enjoy so many Bhogam that is present in the world. Tapona Taptam Vayameva Taptaha. If you do not understand the essence of why you are doing tapas, you are only torturing your own body there. Right, instead of pursuing what needs to be pursued. Ashana jirna vayameva jirna. We are the persons who get destroyed in the process. So vairagya janana tatparyam. The tatparyam vaktri icha. What does Vyasa want to communicate to us? Vairagyam eva atra pradhanam. Iti darshayata munina. Moksha lakshanaha purushartaha. Shantarasaha cha mukhyataya vivaksha vishayatvena suchitaha. There are two things that he wants to convey, that he wants to indicate to us. What are those two things? Moksha lakshanaha purushartaha. Even though he says dharmecha, artecha, kamecha, mokshecha, everything is present here. But look at the end. Why has he given such an end for such great people? मोक्षलक्षणः एव पुरुषार्थः प्रधानः इति गीतायां शान्तरसः एव प्रधानः इति पूर्णप्रबन्धे मुख्यतया विवक्षाविषयत्वेन सूचितः मुनिना व्यासेन एतच्च अंशेन विवृतमेव अन्यैः व्याख्या विधायिभिः. ओन्लि अ पोर्शन् आफ् इट् हेस् बीन् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् बै द commentators on Mahabharata, like I think Neelakantha is one of the persons they have highlighted as one who has written the Vyakhyanam for Mahabharatam. Swayameva cha etat udgirnam tena lokanathena udirna mahamoha magnam ujjihirshata lokam adivimala jnana alokadayina lokanathena. You have to do an anvayam for this. So swayameva lokanathena tena, tena lokanathena by vyasena, athava you can take it as bhishmena, but bhishma is only a vakta here. It is the kavi who wants to try to convey that moksha purushartaha and shantarasam. रैट् सो स्वयमेव तेन लोकनाथेन महर्षिणा व्यासेन उद्गीर्णम् उदितम् हि सेट् दट् उक्तम् उदीर्ण महामोग महामोह मग्नं लोकम् उज्जिहीर्षत उद्धर्तुम् इच्छत उज्जिहीर्षत उद्धर्तुम् इच्छत मुनिन हि वाण्ट्स् टु अप्लिफ्ट् द पीपल् लोकम् उज्जिहीर्षत हौ इस् द लोकम् उदीर्ण महामोह मग्नम् उदीर्ण वास्ट् महामोह इस् भ्रान्तम् People are completely deluded in this world. They think that whatever we see in this world is satyam. And they are attracted towards the things that are there in this world. Aihika sukham, amushmika sukham. They perform, even those people who perform yaga, yajna, punya, papam, everything. You are performing punya because you want to enjoy good deeds. You want to have a better birth next. Nobody does punya to not have a birth. We perform good deeds because we say we want to accumulate punyam. Why do we want to accumulate punyam? Because we want to have a good birth. Why do we want to have a good birth? To do good deeds. Why? You are still in that cycle. You are not thinking of getting out of that cycle. So that is a mahamoha magnam lokam. It is still a mahamoha. It's a great delusion that is there. We think this is something that we have to keep on doing again and again. Nobody wants to try to get out of that chakra of janma and punarjanma. But Vyasa, Adi Karun, Mahakarunikaha Vyasaha. He wants to Paramakarunikaha. They say about Narada, Paramakarunikaha Munihi Saha. That's why he wrote that Bhakti Sutram for us. So, Udirna Mahamoha Magnam Lokam जनम उज्जिहीर्षता उद्धर्तुम् इच्छता महामुनिना आति विमल ज्ञान आलोकदायिना यू जस्ट वांट टू लिफ्ट समवन अप यू हैव टू गिव हिम योर हैंड टू लिफ्ट हिम अप व्हाट इज द हैंड इट इज लाइक अ प्रकाशम दैट ही गिव्स इट इज अ मोहम मोहम इज लाइक एन अंधकारम यू हैव टू गिव हिम प्रकाशम फॉर हिम टू गेट आउट ऑफ दैट अज्ञानम And for that ajnanam to be removed, you need jnanam. Jnanam is the prakasha swarupam. Ati vimala jnanam. Ati vimala jnanam is moksha. That is the only thing that can save people from this. Vidyate hridaya granthihi kriyante cha asya karmani tasmin drishte paravare. When that brahma swarupa is realized, vidyate hridaya granthihi, that attachment that is there towards the worldly enjoyments, vidyate kriyante cha asya karmani, all the karma, whether it is papa karma or punya karma, all of those are gone. He no longer, even if he performs actions in this world, he is no longer attached by the punya or papa that is arrived from that, when he has attained that realization. So that message is given from that Mahabharata or through Gita, which is a part of Mahabharata. Bhagavad Gita, which is one of the Prasthanatrayam, is a Moksha Shastra. Right? So Adi Vimala Jnana Alokadayina Lokanathena, what is he said? Yata yata viparyeti lokatantram asaravate, tada tada virago atra jayate natra samshayaha. Yata yata viparyeti, as and when, we understand viparyeti viparitam sampadyate viparitam sampadyate lokatantram asaravat iti viparita buddhihi manasi jayate tatha viragaha jayate iti na atra samshayaha. There is no doubt about it. So lokatantram means lokaihi tantryamanam yatnena sampadyamanam. Yeah. धर्मार्थ काम तत् साधन लक्षणं वस्तुभूततया अभिमतम् अपि धर्म अर्थ काम इति ऑल थ्री ऑफ देम हैव बीन सेड एज वस्तुभूतम् इन साधनं साधनतया उक्तत्वे अपि मोक्षस्यैव परमसाधनतया उक्तम् अत्र. So lokatantram means loke tantryamanam yatnena sampadyamanam dharma artha kamam. All of these, ultimately, what do we look at it as? Asaravat. Yena yena arjana rakshana kshayadina prakarena asaravat. तुच्छ इन्द्रजालव इन्द्रजालादिवत् यूसेस् हिसेस् इट् इस् माया असारवत् अभिनवगुप्ता बीङ्ग् अड्वकेट् आफ् काश्मीर् शैविसम् विच् इस् आल्सो शैव अद्वैतम् So he says it is asaram. Asaram means he translates it as Indrajala Adivat. Just like a magician who creates an illusory world. In the same manner, this whole thing has been is just a maya which is superimposed on Brahma Swarupam, which is the truth, Satyam. The rest is all maya. It is only an illusion. Indrajalavat, asaravat, viparyeti, viparyeti, pratyuta viparitam sampatyate. If he understands that this everything is just an illusion, tatha tatha, as and when he understands, there slowly a viragaha, there is a detachment that arises in his mind. Each one will stop being important for you. You will start doing things for your body and then slowly you will feel that there is no point as your body grows old, there is no point in, you know, beautifying the body. You will lose that interest in that body. Next, you will start looking at your internal organs of Pashi, you know, Krut, Pipasa, Ityadi. So you will transverse through each and every kosha. There will be a detachment from each and every kosha. Annamayam, Pranamayam, Manomayam. And then you will go to the Brahma Tattva. विरागः जायते इति बहुशः कथयता मुनिना उद्गीर्णम् सो द अन्वयम् गोस् देर् ओके ततश्च शान्तः रसः रसान्तरैः अन्यरसैः शान्तः रसः अनुगम्यमानः भवति तदुपसर्जनत्वेन तदुपसर्जनत्वेन गौणीभावेन अप्रधानत्वेन रसान्तराणाम् अप्रधानत्वेन शान्तः रसः अनुगम्यमानः भवति यतः शान्तरसः एव प्रधानतया भासते अववासते मोक्षलक्षणः पुरुषार्थः अपि पुरुषार्थान्तरैः धर्म अर्थकामैः तदुपसर्जनत्वेन मोक्ष अपेक्षया अन्य पुरुषार्थानाम् उपसर्जनत्वेन अप्रधानत्वेन अनुगम्यमानः अस्ति मोक्षः सर्वैः अन्यपुरुषार्थैः अनुगम्यमानः अस्ति अङ्गित्वेन भासते अङ्गित्वेन विवक्षा विषयः मुनिना वक्तुम् इच्छा अत्रैव अस्ति इति महाभारततात्पर्यं सुव्यक्तमेव अवभासते अङ्गाङ्गिभावश्च यथा रसानां तथा प्रतिपादितमेव कृतियोद्योते इट् इस् बीन् कवर्ड् अबौट् हौ दि अङ्गिरसम् इस् शान्तं द रेस्ट् आफ् दि अदर् रसस् आर् आल्सो अङ्गभूतं has been covered in detail or the angangi bhavaha how the rasa should be whether it is virodhi rasam or not you have bibatsam shringaram everything all rasas are present in mahabharata yet shanta rasa is the pradhanam paramarthika antastatva anapekshaya sharirasya iva angabhutasya rasasya purushartasya cha स्वप्राधान्येन चारुत्वमपि अविरुद्धम् ईवन् इफ् दि अदर् रसास् आर् आल्सो ट्रीटेड् इन् अ नैस् मेनर् पारमार्थिक अन्तस्तत्व अनपेक्षया इफ् वि डोण्ट् सी वेन् वि आर् रीडिङ्ग् महाभारतं देर् आर् 1 lakh वर्सस् इन् महाभारतम् ऐ डोण्ट् नो इफ् इन् मै लैफ् टैम् ऐ केन् स्टडी दि एण्टैर् महाभारतं सो से वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् ओन्लि एट् सेक्षन्स् आफ् इट् And some sections, maybe a few thousands of shlokas we are reading, and that section particularly is very beautiful with Shringara Rasam, or it is very beautiful with Adbhuta Rasam. Each angam also swapradhanyena charutvam api aviruddham eva. You can highlight it and explain it in a beautiful manner, and it still has a beauty. No one denies the beauty of the anga. Sharirasya eva. शरीरस्यापि अङ्गभूतमपि शरीरं तस्य शरीरस्यापि चारुत्वम् अस्ति एव बट् प्रधानतया न भासते स्वप्राधान्येन इफ् ऐ वाण्ट् टु से दट् मै बाडी इस् इम्पार्टेण्ट् ओ ऐ हाव् ब्यूटिफुल् हेण्ड्स् यु नो देर् आर् हेण्ड् डबल्स् एण्ड् पीपल् हू हू इन् मूवीस् they will have people substitute and say they may not have the acting capabilities, but they will just act as doubles in certain areas. So for stunt and all, you will have a stuntman doing the work of the hero, right? He may not be able to act out the emotional scenes, but he will be very good in doing the stunts. So that is how the shariram should be taken as. So shariram as such is beautiful. As an alankara, apanuti alankara is very beautiful. Swapradhanyena charutvam api aviruddham. Each purusharta has been dealt with in Mahabharata separately, and there is a beauty to it. Even if you don't consider shantarasa. So paramarthika antastattva anapekshaya, if you do not consider that paramarthikam antastattvam shantarasam or purushartham, still sharirasya iva yata sharirasya api charutvam asti tatha angabhutasya rasasya api anya rasanam purushartasya cha dharma artha kamanam api swapradhanyena charutvam asti eva tatra na viruddham. Nobody is questioning that. Okay, next is there is a Purvapakshi is asking a question. Nanu Mahabharate Yavan Vipaksha Vishayaha Sa Anukramanyam Sarvayeva Anukrantaha Naja Etat Tatra Drishyate Pratyuta Sarva Purusharta Prabodha Hetutvam Sarvarasa Garbhatvam Cha Mahabharatasya Tasmin Uddeshe Swashabda Niveditatvena Pratiyate. Now Anukramani is a very specific how to say this? So there are many stages for the development of Mahabharata. Mahabharata did not come into this world with 1 lakh verses. It started off with 24,000. It was called Jaya, and then there is a it moved. There is another second stage of the Mahabharatam where it had probably 60,000 verses. And then during the third stage of development, where many upakathas started coming in, and that is the third stage where that is the present available 1 lakh verses Mahabharata. In the first, but the portion that is, I think, repeated in all three stages, where there is no change to that, is the Anukramani, or a section which is supposed to be a summary of the entire Mahabharata. In that Anukramani, it is like a contents of Mahabharata. In that contents, the Moksha Parva is not dealt with. There is no mention of Moksha being the Pradhanam, or there is no importance given to Shantarasam also in that Anukramani. So Mahabharate Yavan Vivaksha Vishayaha, whatever you feel that the Vyasa is trying to say, Vivaksha Vishayaha, Vyasasya, Saha Vishayaha, Anukramanyam Sarvayeva Anukrantaha. It is all present in Anukramani, but Nacha Etat Drishyate, Tatra Drishyate, what is that Etat? Moksha Vishayaha, Shantarasaha cha Tatra na Drishyate, Pratyuta, Sarva Purusharta Prabodha Hetutvam. All purusharthas are important. That is the point mentioned in Anukramani. And sarvarasa garbhatvam cha mahabharatasya iti tatra uktam. Tasmin uddeshe swashabdya niveditatvena pratiyate. So Vyasa himself has said that all purusharthas are important. And all rasas have been said in Mahabharata. Then how do we say that Shantarasa and Moksha is important in Mahabharata? Atra uchyate. The answer here is, Satyam Shantasyaiva Rasasya Angitvam Mahabharate Mokshasya cha Sarva Purusharthebhyaha Pradhanyam iti etat na Swashabda Abhidayitvena Abhideyatvena Anukramanya Darshitam. He accepts it. Satyam, it is true that it is not been shown in Anukramani Swashabda Abhidayitvena Abhideyatvena. It has not been explicitly expressed in Anukramani that Moksha is the most important. Mokshasyaiva pradhanyam sarva purushartebhyaha iti na darshitam. Tathacha shantarasasyaiva angitvam ityapi Mahabharate anukramanya na darshitam. Parantu. So even though he does not say explicitly, see, everybody is not Mahabhavabhuti. Bhavabhuti says in Uttaramacharitam ekorasa karuna eva. Nimitya bhedat. it is like the ocean where you know it shows different budbudam tarangam, all of these are just part of the ocean. And ego rasaha karuna eva, it is only karunam that is the primary rasam, and everything else is just a manifestation of the karuna. Without karunam, nobody is going to feel the intensity of any emotion. The intensity of an emotion is felt only in karunam, he says. But in Mahabharata, Vyasa does not mention anything like that. We only have to understand from whatever that has been said. Darshitam tu vyangyatvena katham bhagavan vasudevascha kirtete atra sanatanaha ityasmin vakye. Anena hi, he says, Bhagavan Vasudevaha atra sanatanaha kirtyate. It is only Bhagavan Vasudeva, Krishna, who is being praised in this section. And why is he important? Sahi satyam amritam chaiva pavitram punyameva cha shashvatam param brahma param jyotihi sanatanam. Bhagavan Vasudeva is satyam, satya swarupaha, amritam, anashwaraha. There is no, he is eternal, pavitram, punyam, punyadayakaha, shashvatam param brahma, eternal paramam brahma. He is the ultimate truth. Param jyotihi is the greatest, the effulgent nature of Brahman. Sanatanaha, he is always ever present. He is the oldest. Sana iti abhyayam. So Sanatanaha is the most ancient. Parama purushartaha. Moksha swarupam brahma. Moksham is non-different from Brahma. Brahma is equal to, Brahman is equal to moksha. There is no such thing as avidya nivrittihi and then Brahma avagatihi. There are no two steps there. Brahma avagatihi, Brahma is equal to moksha. So Vasudevaha eva moksha swarupaha saeva atra kirtyate mahabharate iti vyasasya vakyena eva moksha eva parama purushartaha. Anena hi ayam artaha vyangitvena vivakshitaha yat atra mahabharate pandavadi charitam yat kirtyate tat sarvam avasana virasam avidya prapancha rupancha परमार्थ सत्य स्वरूपस्तु भगवान वासुदेवः अत्र कीर्त्यते. वाच्यार्थम इन दिस एंटायर प्रबंधम मे बी अ स्टोरी ऑफ पांडवास एंड कौरवास. यत् कीर्त्यते पांडवादि चरितं यत् कीर्त्यते तत् सर्वं अवसान विरसम. इट एंड्स इन अ वेरी नॉट बैड नोट और जस्ट टू शो द दैट the life is ephemeral, the ephemeral nature of life. Avasana virasam avidya prapancha rupam. Avidya means not it is not vidya or learning or anything. Avidya is equal to ajnanam, moham. So avidya prapancha rupam cha paramartha satya swarupastu. What is the greatest truth? What is the ultimate truth? And he is of the form of that truth, which is Bhagavan Vasudevaha Atra Kirtyate. Okay, I think I'll stop with this. We'll deal with the rest next time.